So I like to remind you that the aim of these articulations and massage techniques that we are using on the sacroiliac area is to gap these two bones, which is basically the sacrum and the ilium, and here where they meet is the sacroiliac joint. So what we are doing is creating movement which can gap and free this particular joint, which often, you know, becomes a bit dysfunctional and subluxated. So in this technique, what we do, we feel for the sacrum and we place one hand over it in this manner. Then our two fingers, we feel the sacroiliac joint, which is often easy to find because they are the two little dimples that we have towards the end of our lower back. And in some people they are quite visible. And what do we do with the fingers? We push in this direction and that direction as to gap away the ilium from the sacrum. Okay, so this finger pushes towards me and this finger in that direction. Now, we need to relax a bit, ground ourselves, and we start to feel that when they breathe in, the sacrum goes in that direction, because that is what happens. When we take air in to accommodate the diaphragm coming down and the lungs coming down, the spine stretches downwards. And we assist it slightly to come down. And when she breathes out, we push the bottom part of the sacrum in that direction. So we are basically helping this movement, okay? While at the same time pulling the ilium away from the sacrum. Now, for a while, at the beginning, we can do it following the breath, but after a while, we don't need to really be too concerned with that. We gently push down and we feel again a process of release. Those of you that have seen some of my other videos, like the one on the temporal mandibular joint, what happens when you push a bone in a certain direction, and very often you will feel that the bone will remain stuck or will remain immobile for a while in that position. So you hold it there, you encourage it. So like if the sacrum goes down, like on the in-breath, it goes down and you have your hand on it and you feel it, that it has gone down. You might, after a few times that you go up and down, feel that the sacrum remains immobile in inspiration. It just stays like that there. So you don't try to push it up. Matter of fact, you encourage it and you hold it in that position. What often happens is that you hold for 3 to 4 minutes, and after a while, there is a sense of relief, or I would say release, better word. And then it like, wow, and it lets go, and it goes up again on its own accord, and this time it's got a much better movement. So again, then you test it, you push up, you push down, you push up, you push down. Remember, you're pushing up with the heel towards the bottom part of the sacrum. and you are pushing down with the tip of the fingers on the top of, from the top of the sacrum. So it's like this and like that, like this and like that. So after that release has happened, you will feel that the sacrum moves a lot better. Now, the ways in which it can become immobile or in craniosacral therapy, it's called going into neutral, can be into flexion, or it could be into a slight rotation. You feel it, follow it. So remember, push up, push down to start with. You can do it feeling the breathing. But at the end, it's not even necessary. If it doesn't come very easy to do it following the breathing, just do it by itself. Just push up, and then you will feel a recoiling action, like zzz, it goes back. Push up, push down. And what happens if you are really attentive to that, it will happen at some stage that it will go into what is called neutral. It means it will remain immobile in a particular direction. So you hold it there, you keep it like that, in what also is called the still point, and you hold it for as long as necessary, often it's 2 to 3, 4 minutes, until then you feel a sense of release. And when there is that release, then you nicely push up and push down, push up and push down, and this time the movement will be a lot easier. Now, next, again, in these techniques to move the ilium away from the sacrum, or gapping the joint of the sacroilium, there is this next technique, which again is a bit subtle but very gentle and one of my all-time favorites. So I put the heel of my hand on her iliac crest border, closer to me, then this hand goes beneath her ilium, front anterior, the front part of the ilium, and what I'm doing, I'm pushing with both hands very gently the ilium away from the sacrum. Okay, so this hand is doing this, and this hand is doing this. Quite simple. Now, when you become familiar with this movement, you can add a very subtle variation, but quite efficacious in achieving this gap of the sacroilium. And what it is with this hand, you push the ilium and slightly lift it up, meaning you create this wave-like movement. So this is pushing in this direction, and this is going slightly like this. Okay, so you're taking the ilium, and you're doing this to it. It's a little circumduction, little rotation. Circumduction is a better word. Okay? But if it doesn't come to you easy, don't worry, okay? Just gently do the one pushing it away. Very nice gapping. Of course, you can do it in one side, then you do it on the other side. And if you haven't done it already, then you do that lovely technique of pushing up and down the sacrum, which we did before. And And normally you should start feeling things moving a lot better.